Hello everyone, in this video, I want to show you how you can intercept HTTPS traffic so that you can inspect it and even modify it. To do this, we're going to use a nice little app called Proxyman. You have the link to download it in the description. Now, full disclosure, this video has been sponsored by Proxyman. However, all the features I'm gonna use in the video are available for free in the app, so you don't need to pay anything to apply the technique I'm going to show you. So I have a big thank you to Proxyman for sponsoring this video, and now let's get to it. As you can see, I've implemented a simple Swift UI app that queries an API and that receives data about upcoming movies that are about to be released in theaters. And if I move to the code that makes the network call, you can see that the API call uses HTTPS, which should make it harder for us to intercept and inspect the network call because HTTPS means that the network calls are being encrypted. But as we're going to see, by using Proxyman, it's gonna be actually fairly easy to see the details of this network traffic. So I've opened Proxyman, and as you can see, it's displaying all of the network traffic that's going through my laptop. So the first thing we want to do is to filter it so that we only see the traffic that's going through my app running on the iOS simulator. So the way to do it is that I'm going to relaunch my app. And as you can see, when I've relaunched my app, it's no longer displaying any data. This might seem weird, but it's totally normal. Let me explain. So we are back in Proxyman, and I'm going to filter so that we only see the network calls made by my app. So I'm selecting the simulator here. It's called Intercept HTTPS because it's the name that I've given to my iOS app. And we can see network call made by my app right here. This network call was successfully intercepted by Proxyman. However, as you can see, it resulted in an internal error. And this is perfectly normal because what Proxyman is doing is that it's putting itself in the middle between your app and the backend that your app is making requests to. The thing is, this is what's also known as a man-in-the-middle attack. So here it's being used as a legitimate technique. You're using it to inspect your app, but this same technique could be used in the wild by an, we could say, adversary party in order to hack your app, to gather information about what your users are doing, or even to change the data that your users are receiving. So it's totally normal that iOS blocks us by default here, and it's a very, very good thing security-wise. However, since here we know what we are doing, we want to allow Proxyman to monitor the HTTPS traffic. So we are going to do that, and to do it, I'm going to click on the Install Certificate button here. So I'm moving the window to make sure that you can see it. You can see that we need to do three things. First, we need to install a root certificate on the Mac. Then we're going to have to install and trust this certificate on the simulator. And this is equivalent to telling the simulator, hey, it's okay for you to allow Proxyman to monitor network calls. And then we'll reboot the simulators. So I'm gonna do it. So first, I'm going to install the certificate on my Mac. So as you can imagine, it's something that only needs to be done once. Okay, it's done. Now I'm going to prepare my simulators. It's been done successfully, and I'm going to reboot the simulator to finish that. All right, so the simulator has been rebooted, so I'm going to close this window. I'm going to relaunch the app, and as you can see, now we are successfully intercepting the HTTPS traffic. So I'm just going to close the simulator, and let's have a look at what we see. We can see the request that was made in full. So we can see it was made to api.themoviedb.org. And then we can see the path and all of the query string parameters. We can inspect all of the headers of the request, all of its body also, even though in this case, there is no body on that request. And we can do the same for the response. We can see the headers and we can see the body, which is the JSON that our app has received. So this is already super useful when you're debugging your app because it means that you can see all of the details of the network traffic in real time. And the big advantage is that you didn't need to change anything to the code of the app. You didn't need to add logs to the console, anything like that. So it's super transparent. You don't need to change anything. The only thing that we had to do was to install this certificate on the simulator and on the Mac so that we could intercept the network traffic. But we can take it even further because in addition to inspecting HTTPS traffic, we can also modify it. So for this, I'm going to create what Proxyman calls a breakpoint. It's the same logic than for a breakpoint in the debugger, except that it will be triggered by a network call being made rather than by the execution of the code reaching a given line. So I'm creating the breakpoint. I'm going to call it upcoming movies call. And as you can see, it's going to trigger whenever there is a call being made to the same URL. We could make it broader if we wanted, because as you can see, we can use wildcards, for example, and we'll see that the breakpoint will trigger both on the request and the response, and we'll see why both options can be interesting. And now I'm going to reopen the simulator and I'm going to do a pull to refresh so that the network call is made once again. As you can see, the network call was made once again, the breakpoint triggered, it opened a big window, so let me just resize it so that you can see it fully. And so you can see it's a breakpoint on the request. So what we see here is the request that's being sent by our app, and we have a chance to inspect it, and also if we want to modify it. Now, one thing to keep in mind the first time that you do this, because it can be very tricky, is that all the time that you spend on this view where you can inspect the request and then the response, all the time you spend there count towards the timeout of your network call. And by default, when you use URL session, I think the network call have a default timeout of 30 seconds. So if you spend more than 30 seconds on this screen, your network call will time out. So actually, in order to be able to record the video without having to rush, I'm going to show you that I change the timeout explicitly. I put it to 5 minutes. So please disregard this comment. It's not correct. I changed it since then. So I put 5 minutes. Just be aware of it, because if you're not, you might get into a situation where like your network calls are erroring out and you don't understand why. So now let's go back to Proxyman and let's modify the outgoing request. So we're going to change it so that instead of tapping the upcoming endpoint, we tap this other endpoint called top rated, which returns the top rated movies of all time according to IMDb. So we're going to run the modified request. We got the answer. And if I look at the body of the answer, you can see that now we no longer have the upcoming movies, but the top rated ones. So as you can expect, the number one movie is The Shawshank Redemption, because it's the highest rated movie on IMDb. And what's nice is that just like we modified the request, we can also modify the response if we want. So for example, we're going to take the second movie. So the second highest rated movie is The Godfather. And just for the fun of it, we're going to change its title. We're going to rename it to The Godmother. I'm going to actually open the simulator so that you can see what happens as soon as I execute the modified response. I'm executing it. And you can see it displayed the response on the screen. And we can see that the modification that I made is also displayed. So that's interesting, first because it shows you that this can be a very useful tool if you want to simulate an error, for example. Well, you can do it on any app and you don't need to implement a fully fledged mocking feature inside the app, so it can be a big time saver. And it also shows us why iOS by default absolutely refuses to have the network traffic be intercepted when it's HTTPS, is that, as you can see, I've been able to change the answer from the backend. So here, it's all fun and games, but imagine that I'm doing this when you're running your banking app. That becomes a much, much more serious issue. And that actually concludes what I wanted to show you in this video. So as we've seen, by using Proxyman, we can super easily intercept all of the HTTPS and of course also the HTTP traffic of any iOS app running in the simulator. And it can be super convenient if we want to debug the network calls of an iOS app without having to change anything to its code base. And we also saw that we can take it even further and use Proxyman to set breakpoints that allow us to change the outgoing request and also to modify the incoming response. And that can be super useful if we want to reproduce a very specific issue without having to develop a fully fledged mocking feature inside our app. And if you want to try it for yourself, you've got the link in the description to download Proxyman. Once again, I have a big thank you to Proxyman for sponsoring this video. If you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next ones. Thank you for watching and see you next time.